What's up, everybody? Gen X Dividend Investor here. I hope everyone is primed for the new year and is ready to make 2021 absolutely awesome. Make it a year of self-improvement. If you've been putting off exercising, then start today. If you've been overeating, then stop. If you are ready to take your financial management and investing to the next level, then congratulations, 2021 is your year. Anyways, in this video, I'm going to tell you about the stocks that are in the ultra-rare 1515 Dividend Club. Then after that, I'm going to show you some fascinating info about yield on cost of various stocks of mine at different points in time, including the Dividend Club ones. Then I'll show you some new merch I just added to my Teespring store based on recommendations from people in my YouTube comments and on my Discord. Finally, I'll end this video with a valuable life story that is worth hearing and reflecting on, so I recommend you watch this entire video. If you do watch the very end, then please leave a comment down below so I know who my rockstar viewers are. Okay, let's get into it. The 1515 Dividend Club is a new classification term I made up for US companies that have been increasing their dividend for at least 15 consecutive years and that have a 1-year, a 3-year, a 5-year, a 10-year, and a 15-year dividend compound annual growth rate of at least 15%. I'll be using my Best Dividend Spreadsheet 2.0 product in this analysis, which is a free service for any of my Patreon aristocrats or kings. I want to thank Drip Investing, who helped me narrow down this list and find 4 companies that made it into the elite 1515 Dividend Club. Also, if you know of a US company that meets my criteria for being in the prestigious Dividend 1515 Club, then please leave me a comment down below. And as always, don't listen to any YouTube video and blindly rush out and invest. Instead, listen as a way to learn about some companies, and if something sounds compelling, then start your actual research due diligence process and obviously dig into important things such as growth trends, your belief in future prospects, if the price looks good to you, etc. Okay, I'll list these stocks in order of least consecutive years of dividend increases to most. To kick things off, we have Texas Instruments, ticker TXN. They are a company that was founded in 1930 and are now known for their calculators and their semiconductors. We see that they have 16 consecutive years of dividend increases and an astounding 25% 3-year dividend growth rate. You can calculate that their 1-year dividend CAGR is 22.1%, their 5-year is 21%, their 10-year is 21.7%, and their 15-year dividend CAGR is 26.99%. That is absolutely stunning, and they are almost in the 2020 club, save for the fact that they are still 3 years short for consecutive number of years of dividend increases needed to join the 2020 list. Analysts are rating them a hold. They have a nice 67% payout ratio, an okay 2.5% yield, and a 30 PE. By the way, one neat capability you can do in my spreadsheet is to quickly compare companies. So let's say you wanted to compare Texas Instruments with another company, let's say Microsoft. You see that Pepsi and Coke are currently in my tool. Let me switch them to Texas Instruments and Microsoft. What my spreadsheet does is highlight the company that has the better metric in green versus yellow for the company with the worst metric. So for example, we see that Texas Instruments have a hold analyst rating, so it's in yellow, versus Microsoft that's in green because analysts have rated it a buy. Then you can scroll down to compare their stock price trends, their dividend payout trends, their dividend yield trends, and then a bunch of other metrics. I love it looking at companies in the same industry like Home Depot versus Lowe's or AT&T versus Verizon or whatever to get a quick visual sense of how they compare. Texas Instruments has a great 25-year average annual return of 13.5%, which is significantly better than SPY's, which had a 9.56% annual average return, which means Texas Instruments gave you about 2.5x as much return as SPY. Nice. Okay, let's move on. The second company out of 4 that made it into the 1515 Dividend Club is A. O. Smith Corporation, ticker AOS, which makes water heaters and boilers and was founded in 1904. I think it's so freaking cool to see companies that have been around for over 100 years. We see that they have 27 consecutive years of dividend increases and an astounding 23% 3-year dividend growth rate. You can calculate that their 1-year dividend CAGR is 18.4%, their 5-year is 24.6%, their 10-year is 21.5%, and their 15-year dividend CAGR is 15.78%. Amazing. Analysts are rating them a hold. They have a nice 49% payout ratio, a relatively low 1.87% yield, and a 28.6 PE. AOS has an incredible 25-year average annual return of 14%, which blows SPY out of the water by almost a 3-to-1 ratio. Okay, the third program out of 4 that made it into the ultra-rare 1515 Dividend Club is Cintas, ticker CTAS, a company founded in 1929 which provides corporate identity uniform programs, logo mats, restroom and cleaning supplies, and a variety of other products and services. We see they have 38 consecutive years of dividend increases and an astounding 25% 3-year dividend growth rate. You can calculate their 1-year dividend CAGR is 24.4%, their 5-year is 24.6%, their 10-year is 18.4%, and their 15-year dividend CAGR is 15.65%. Wow. Analysts are rating them a hold. They have a great 30% payout ratio, a low 1.04% yield, and a 39.5 PE. Syntus has an incredible 25-year average annual return of 15%, which destroys SPY's returns by an astounding 3.5x. Okay, the final incredible 1515 Dividend Club company is none other than Lowe's, ticker LOW, a home improvement company founded in 1921. It looks like 2021 will be Lowe's 100-year anniversary. We see that they have 57 consecutive years of dividend increases and a great 17.8% 3-year dividend growth rate. You can calculate that their 1-year dividend CAGR is 15.7%, their 5-year is 20.2%, their 10-year is 19.4%, and their 15-year dividend CAGR is 24.73%. Analysts are rating it a buy. They have an awesome 31% payout ratio, a low 1.47% yield, and a 23 PE. Lowe has the best 25-year average annual return of the Dividend Club stocks at an earth-shattering 16.45%, and thus destroys SPY by almost a factor of 5. Isn't it interesting how each stock in the club performed better than the previous one as the number of consecutive years of dividend increases went up? Now, I'm personally long at Home Depot, but unfortunately it didn't have the metrics to make this elite list. Okay, now I want to show you some various forward estimated yield on cost for a bunch of stocks. I used 5-year CAGR just to estimate the dividend growth rate for the stocks on the top of this chart, and then I used a 15-year CAGR for the Dividend Club stocks. So let's look at a few examples. Take Apple. Its current yield is so low at 0.62% at the time I'm creating this script that even 20 years from now, your yield on cost is only estimated to be 4.58%, assuming they keep increasing at their 5-year CAGR of 10.5%. So what does a 0.62% yield mean, and how's it calculated? Well, Apple's dividend is at $0.205 per share per quarter, which means it's at 20.5 cents per share per quarter, which means it's at 82 cents per share per year. One share costs around $132 right now, so the yield is the annual dividends paid out divided by share price, which equals 0.62%. So if you bought $100 of Apple shares today, you'd be getting about 62 cents of dividend income a year. Not so hot. However, in the short time I've had Apple, I'm up around 250% of stock appreciation in it. So even though I only invested $67,000 when I bought my Apple shares, those are now worth around $238,000 at market close today. Insanity. And then if we assume Apple increases its dividends by 10.5% a year for 20 years, then in 20 years your yield on cost would be 4.58%, which means your $100 investment in Apple, assuming your drip was off, would now be yielding $4.58 rather than 62 cents. Now let's look at AbbVie, which has both a great starting yield and a great track record of increasing their dividend, albeit in the short time they've been a separate company. Right now, AbbVie has about a 5% yield. That means if you bought $100 worth of AbbVie stock, you'd be yielding about $5, which is already more than your Apple shares would be yielding in 20 years, based on our estimates. At year 20, if AbbVie had been aggressively increasing their dividends by 20.8% a year, then your yield on cost would be about 223%, which means you'd be yielding $223 a year. Do I think that AbbVie will keep increasing their dividend by 20% a year? No, I doubt it, since they're already starting high. Let's take another example, this time J&J. Their estimated 20-year yield on cost is 9%. How about AT&T? Their yield on cost today is 7.25%, but their CAGR is low, so their 20-year yield on cost only increases to 11%. As you all probably know, AT&T has some very real risk in their debt, so don't discount that. They have loans, pension liabilities, etc., and they're taking great steps, but at the same time their debt may increase even with the 5G auctions. So there is real risk that your investment sours, but that's why the starting yield is so insane. You are paying for that risk, and you are hoping it pays off. Now let's look at the Dividend Club yield on costs. So we see Texas Instruments has an absolutely wild year 20 yield on cost at 300%, higher than any of my other ones. A. O. Smith is at a healthy 35%, which is great. Syntus is mediocre at 15%, and Lowe's is awesome at 122%. So if we scan a few of mine, you see Caterpillar is about 10%, we see Home Depot has a great 155% at year 20, Leggett & Platt is a medium 10%, McDonald's is at 10%, 3M's at 27%, Pepsi's at 14%, and Procter & Gamble's only at 4.25%, as a few examples. Feel free to take a screenshot if you want to see various estimated examples of year-on-cost dividend yields at different points in time. So one takeaway from this is that there are a lot of factors that influence how I invest, including that I like some yield now, some down the road, sometimes I focus on total returns over time, sometimes a bit of each. Thus, there's a lot of nuance on how you build your dividend portfolios. If you'd like me to do an entire video to explain yield on cost more and how exactly you can calculate it at various points in time and how useful it is or isn't as a financial metric, then please tell me so in the comments below. Now I'll show you some merch I just added to my Teespring store based on recommendations of people in my YouTube comments and on my Discord. So I added 3 new merch sayings onto my mugs and tops. Number one was from Random Rolly in my YouTube comments, who suggested, "When I drip, you drip, we drip." Number two was from Pierre on my Discord, who suggested, "Buy the dip, make it drip." Pierre actually has a YouTube channel called PK Investing that you should check out. Finally, the third one I added was from Dan in my YouTube comments, who suggested, "Dividend investing, this is the way." Thanks, folks, I appreciate your suggestions. Note, you'll notice on all my older merch items that I'm donating 10% of profits to St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, but these three new sayings might take a few days for the Teespring customer support to add the charitable donations capabilities in. The link to my merch store is in the description of this video. Okay, now I'm going to tell you a valuable story about life I found online that is worth hearing and reflecting on. A popular speaker started off a seminar by holding up a $20 bill. A crowd of 200 had gathered to hear him speak. He asked, "Who would like this $20 bill?" All 200 hands went up. He said, "I'm going to give this $20 to one of you, but first let me do this." He crumpled the bill up. He then asked, "Who still wants it?" Everyone had their hands still raised. "Well," he replied, "what if I do this?" Then he dropped the bill on the ground and stomped on it with his shoes. He picked it up and showed it to the crowd. The bill was all crumpled and dirty. "Now who wants it?" All the hands still went up. My friends, I've just showed you a very important lesson. No matter what I did to the money, you still wanted it because it did not decrease in value. It was still worth $20. Many times in our lives, life crumples us and grinds us into the dirt. We make bad decisions or deal with poor circumstances. We feel worthless. But no matter what has happened or what will happen, you will never lose your value. You are special. Don't ever forget it. That reminds me of a quote from the brilliant Einstein who said, "Everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing it's stupid." Moral of those anecdotes? You are special even if you haven't recognized your own talents. You are special even when you're at your lowest, darkest, and loneliest moments. You are special. Okay, moving on. Now I'd like to shout out my higher tier Patreons. So my first thank you goes out to Pork Chips. Then I'd also like to thank Mike Mitch for signing up. And I'd like to thank you, the viewer, for watching all the way to the end. It really means the world to me. Please consider hitting the thumbs up button, subscribing if you haven't yet, and click that bell notification. And if you got any value from watching this video, I'd like to pitch a few things. First, if you're interested to start investing, then consider using my M1 brokerage referral link in the description of this video. M1 normally runs promotions where if you click a referral link and then open a new non-retirement brokerage account and transfer some cash into it, then we both can get some free cash, usually $10. It's free cash, don't pass it up. I would also really appreciate it if you would consider clicking on my Amazon affiliate link in the description of this video and then go shopping online. As an Amazon associate, I earn from qualifying purchases. If you'd like some hilarious investing merch, then click on my Teespring link in the description of this video. And best of all, consider directly supporting me by signing up as a Patreon aristocrat to gain special access to my Discord channels as well as to my 2.0 spreadsheet. Finally, I'd like to invite you to join my free dividend Discord. Join in, and I can almost promise you will make new friends from all around the world, as well as get to talk about dividend investing 24 hours a day. Happy New Year, and I'll talk to you again real soon.
I am not a financial advisor, and these videos are for entertainment, inspiration, and educational purposes only. Investing of any kind involves risk. I am only sharing my opinion with no guarantee of gains or losses on investments.